In this video, I'm going to cover how to use the brand new Composite View in RX6 in a music production context using samples from a multi-mic'd drum kit. To download these files for your own use in RX6, visit the RX website and download the folder called Music Production Drum Samples. I'm going to start this tutorial in Pro Tools and finish the tutorial in RX6's brand new Composite View, but if you're only using the files in RX6 and not starting from Pro Tools, jump to a later part of this video. But for now, I'll walk you through getting things from Pro Tools into RX6. If you've opened the test files in Pro Tools, you should see 5 files: kick, snare, overhead left, overhead right, and room. If we listen back to the samples, we should hear a drum pattern with an audible cell phone ringing as the drummer plays. To transfer the noisy drum pattern into RX6 from Pro Tools, I'm going to highlight a region where the cell phone ringing is audible. Now, before we export things into RX6, it's important that all the files have matching sample rates, but if they don't match, we can always adjust the sample rate size by using the Resample tool in RX6. Now, I'll head to Audio Suite, Noise Reduction, RX6 Connect. Once we're in the RX Connect window, we want to make sure that we choose Mono Mode. Also, I have the Repair Round Trip tab selected because once I'm finished repairing my audio in RX6, I'm going to want to bring it back into Pro Tools for further editing. I'll press Send. Now that we're in RX6, we can see the 5 files. I should mention that a minimum of 2 files and a maximum of 16 files can be collapsed into a Composite View tab. We should see kick, snare in tab 2, overhead left in tab 3, overhead right in tab 4, and room in tab 5. Composite View combines all active tabs into one composite tab that allows you to apply the same processing to multiple files simultaneously. So I'll collapse the files into one composite view by pressing this little arrow icon. Now I'll identify one of the moments in the track that has the cell phone ringing and repair it using spectral repair. I'm going to switch to my time and frequency selection tool and just have a listen. So what I'll do is create a selection right around here. And now I'm going to use spectral repair to attenuate that distracting ringing. I'm going to call up a preset, drum attenuation, and you'll notice that I have strength set to about 1.6. My surrounding region length is grabbing information from just below my sample and a little bit above. My before and after weighting is set to 0, and the direction of interpolation is vertical. Now I'll press process. Let's have a listen to the results of our first pass using spectral repair in Composite View. So here's before. And here's after. The results are pretty dramatic. So as you noticed, all processing and edits applied in Composite View will be applied to all the tracks, but if I want, I can exit Composite View by pressing this arrow icon once more and use the undo history list to undo changes that I've made to individual files. For example, overhead right. Here's before, and here's after. For more information and to download your own files to use in RX6, head to iZotope.com/RX.